Yes, hello viewers. Today we want to look at another element of the business plan, which is the production plan. Production plan. So this production plan is important because it shapes an individual. If you want to produce something, just imagine. As a student, you want to make juice. You ask yourself, what type of juice? That's the product. What type of juice? So we shall see you focusing on the what? On the product. Product to be produced. What type of product? It is juice. So, what type of product? Maybe mango juice, maybe pineapple juice. So ask yourself, if you want to make juice, where are you going to make that juice from? That is the business site and location. Business site and what? And location. Then, having known that this is where I'm going to make the juice from, ask yourself another question. Just as you think, what am I going to use? What am I going to use to make that juice? Those are the raw materials, things like the mango juice, the mango itself. So we have raw materials. So raw materials, you can buy the mangoes. So the mangoes are going to be mixed with sugar and other elements that you may include in the raw materials that we're going to mix to make the what? The juice. But again, as you're mixing, which means you yourself, you are needed to be part of the production. So we say that you need, you represent labor. So you're part of the what? The labor needed, which we call the labor what? Requirements. So we need an individual who's going to mix or who's going to supervise the machine as it is blending or mixing the juice. If you're not mixing it yourself, it will be the machine. Or you're using the machine to operate because the machine will not switch itself on. It needs an individual to operate it. So you need that, you also need a machine. So we have machines or machinery requirements. Requirements. It's another element needed to make the product. And in these machines, some people think of the complicated machines like, imagine generators. No, we start even from a knife. You're going to be cutting the mangoes into small pieces. So think of a knife, simple machines, before even you think of the advanced. But think of those simple machines. So machinery, maybe a blender to use to blend the juice and so on. Those are machinery required. But remember, this machine at times, some of them will not operate without electricity. So you need power. You need what? You need power, like electricity or biogas, depending on what you're using and where you're located, or solar. Then you need water. So we shall put water under what? Utilities. Though at times you find some combination where they say power and utilities. But quantify the water under what? Utilities. Will be a water bills. So put water, because water is also going to be mixed in what? In making the juice. After you've finished making the juice, remember, you have a filter, maybe it's a filtering machine, it is also under machinery requirements. So, after the juice has been made, it needs to be packed. So, think about the packaging. So, we have the packaging materials. So, you're going to pack the juice, maybe in a glass, maybe in a cup, depending on the packaging machine. Material that you've chosen, even if it is to keep it aside, ready for maybe sale or for further processing, you need some packaging what? Materials. So you see that we thought about, first of all, think about the product that you're going to produce. Where are you going to produce it from? This business side and location. What are you going to use? I'm going to use raw materials. Yeah. Because you want to produce, you want to produce, that's why you need what? Raw materials. You don't start it. I'm going to produce and then you buy in bread and then you make it what? You make it bread. But interesting, if you want to make bread, you need wheat, you need milk, you need eggs. Those are the raw materials you want to mix. Labor requirements, machinery requirements, power, utilities, and packaging materials. Those are some of the elements included as you're planning for production. But remember, they are residues that do not go into the juice. So what you do to them, you may throw them away, but you throw them into maybe a container. So you need to get up to the disposables. Those items that you do not want, where do you place them? Because there are those who recycle them. We shall see how you handle the unwanted materials in the business. Not every unwanted material is a waste, but we shall see later on in production management. But here, as you plan for this, you need to plan for those waste disposals. So we have an element called disposal. Waste disposal requirements. And have waste disposal requirements. Waste disposal requirements. When you need a container, you need a polythene bag. Think about those items that you want to dispose of the waste materials to be included in your production what? In your production plan. Of course, all these ones are going to be costed. All of them are going to be costed. Say you rent the place, that is the business site and location. You buy raw materials, the labor is going to be paid, the machinery is going to be bought, the electricity has to be paid. Utilities, water has to be paid, all of them have to be costed. And because they are costed, that's why you can include an element called projected production costs. So, production costs expected. So, this one will show the summary of all those elements and their respective costs, like a production budget expenditure. Production budget expenditure. It will show the items you're spending on production and how much you're spending on those items. So production cost expected or production expenditure budget. It is going to be included in the production plan. So what happens in case you told in paper 2, LFO, or paper 1 of LFO, entrepreneurship, and told to prepare production plan. Prepare production plan. Let's look at an example. They are saying you are operating a juice processing plant in your community. Prepare production plan for your business. What you do? Give it a name, because the name of the business has already been given. So all your work is to look for a name for the business. Maybe I'll say Senville Juice Processing Business. PO Box 30 Nakawa. It is advisable to write the location that you converse at about or you converse at with, because when you describe the location, you'll be telling us the village, the district, and maybe the division. So it is better for you to be able to tell us exactly the places you know. Remember, you're not supposed to write the name of the school anywhere else. Example script. So then you write the document identity, production. Plan. That's it. So you've written the address and the document identity. So select any of the items. You don't need to write them in the order. Any items that you remember, you use them to defend. Maybe it is 7 marks. The 1 mark goes for document name and the address of the business. So if there are 7 marks, you remain with 6 marks. Each element carries a mark. So we'll start with maybe machinery requirements. Remember the business is using what? It's a juice processing. And it's a simple business, maybe. So you write a paragraph, you have machinery requirements. Machinery requirements, a comma, and then you say the business uses a blender to process the juice. The business uses a blender to process the juice. So you say that the business uses, the language we are using is present simple tense. The business uses a blender to process the juice. So then you select another item. Maybe raw materials used, comma, you say the business uses mangoes, sugar and carrots. Maybe those are the raw materials that are used in mixing the juice. Select another item, power. The business uses electricity to run the blender. So the blender uses electricity, that's why person is saying the business uses electricity as power. Think about another one. Maybe labor requirements. Labor requirements. You say the business uses one production manager who earns 200,000 per month, 200,000 shillings per month. Something that I had forgotten, which is important. Remember I said that we have the production cost expenditure, which means all these elements have to be costed. On our first point where I wrote the machinery requirements, it is better to tell us the business uses a blender made to process the juice, which costs maybe 200,000 shillings. You write some cost on the machine. Then the raw materials used, the business uses marble, sugar and carrots, which costs maybe 20,000 shillings per day. Power, the business uses electricity to run the blender, totally to an amount of maybe 10,000 per month. You include the cost in every element as you describe in the production, because we are interested in also knowing how much is used in making that particular product. So it's important. Don't forget the costs. Maybe you can think about the packaging material as well as another element. Packaging materials, then you say the business uses tins, plastic containers, and boxes, which costs maybe you could again think of it, a total cost of the packaging material, which costs 15,000 shillings. So that is how we describe your production plan. Measure the item, use present simple tense to describe the item very well, and also measure the cost on every item you write. And I've said that they are not in order. And even as you try to remember the elements of the production plan, just imagine of any product you know how to make. It could be popcorn. You want to make popcorn. What do you need? You need a machine that makes those popcorn. You need the popcorn itself, or the maize seeds, and you need oil. So all those are elements, and then you quantify them where they're supposed to be. Then you cost. When you cost, you need to tell us. Then by the end of the day, we shall know how much cost is needed in production of a particular item or product that you're producing. Thank you so much for listening. Hope that you'll send your comments. I remain Sejong Henry, teacher of entrepreneurship.